Ladies and gents, welcome to the channel of truth, where truth reigns. I'm making this video to show you that there's different sides to the story of heaven. And on YouTube and the media only shows one-sided argument. But before we even look at the case of heaven, a lot of people are saying, let's kill him, let's give the death penalty. And when you ask them why the death penalty, they all say that by killing this man, there wouldn't be any more pedophiles and there wouldn't be any more crimes like this. But the fact is, pedophilia is a mental disorder. So if you kill this man, that means that you would have to... If you kill this man, it's not going to stop pedophilia. And if you do, if you believe that, then that means you have to kill every person with mental disorder. And that means it's not going to solve anything. We're not going to stop mental disorder by killing the people with mental disorder. So I would like to start my video with this notion that it would be stupid to think that by killing a mentally ill person, you will stop a crime. It doesn't solve anything. In this video, we will cover some of the contested points of this case.
What percent of pedophiles kill their victims? The percentage of pedophiles who kill their victims is relatively low. While data on this specific aspect of pedophilia is limited, research indicates that the vast majority of pedophiles do not commit murder. Most child sexual abuse cases involve non-lethal offenses. Studies of child abduction and homicide have shown that cases involving sexual motives and subsequent murder represent a small proportion of overall child sexual abuse cases. For example, research by the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children indicates that in cases of non-family child abductions, which may involve sexual assault, fewer than 1% result in the murder of the child. In general, child sexual abusers are more likely to use coercion, manipulation, or threats rather than physical violence leading to death. However, those who do escalate to murder, especially in highly publicized cases, tend to generate significant attention, which can sometimes distort perceptions of the frequency of such crimes. 3. Staging the scene. Asterisk. Some offenders may try to stage the crime scene to make it appear as though the death was accidental, a suicide, or caused by someone else. This can mislead investigators and delay justice. 4. Using technology to cover tracks. Asterisk. In some cases, offenders might try to delete digital footprints, such as text messages, location data, or internet searches, to reduce the chances of being traced by digital forensics. 5. Moving or relocating the victim. Asterisk. A tactic known as body dumping involves committing the crime in one location and then transporting the victim's body to another location. This complicates the investigation by separating the crime scene from where the body is found. 6. Attempts to blame others. Asterisk. Some offenders may plant evidence or mislead investigators into suspecting another person, shifting the focus away from themselves. While many offenders employ these tactics, modern forensic science, law enforcement techniques, and digital investigations often help detect and trace the perpetrators despite their efforts to cover up the crime. What percent of pedophiles kill their victims? The percentage of pedophiles who kill their victims is relatively low. While data on this specific aspect of pedophilia is limited, research indicates that the vast majority of pedophiles do not commit murder. Most child sexual abuse cases involve non-lethal offenses. Studies of child abduction and homicide have shown that cases involving sexual motives and subsequent murder represent a small proportion of overall child sexual abuse cases. For example, research by the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children indicates that in cases of non-family child abductions, which may involve sexual assault, fewer than 1% result in the murder of the child. In general, child sexual abusers are more likely to use coercion, manipulation, or threats rather than physical violence leading to death. However, those who do escalate to murder, especially in highly publicized cases, tend to generate significant attention, which can sometimes distort perceptions of the frequency of such crimes.
Let's get a gynecologist's opinion on Haven's situation, and then we will look at the hospital photo.
ኤክስፒሪንስ እና የራሴን ሪፍሌክሽን ለመስጠት ነው የመጣሁት እና ፒክቸሩን ሳየው የተላከልኝ ፒክቸር በዋናነት ብልት ላይ የደረሰውን ጉዳት የሚያሳየው ፒክቸር ነው እና እሱ ላይ ነው አስተያየት መስጠት የምፈልገው። ፒክቸሩ ሲታይ እንግዲህ የብልት መግቢያው ወይም ቫጂናል ኦርፊስ የሚባለው በእንግሊዝኛው መግቢያ በሩ ላይ ያለው መስፋት ይታይበታል። ሰፊ ነው መስፋቱ። የሚጠበቅ አይደለም በዚህ እድሜ በሰባት እና በስምንት ዓመት መካከል ባለች ህፃን ልጅ እድሜ እንደዚህ ሰፊ የሆነ ኦርፊስ አይታይም አይጠበቅም እና በጣም ሰፊ ከልክ ያለፈ የሰፋ ነው። ሁለተኛ ደግሞ በዙሪያው መቅላት ይታይበታል። የድንግልና ምልክት እና የጠርዙ ከናፍሩ ዙሪያው በሙሉ የድንግልና ምልክት ቤዙ እና ዙሪያው መቅላት ይታይበታል። ሶስተኛ እንዲሁም በፊንጢጣ እና በቫጂናል ኦርፊስ ወይም በብልት መካከል ያለው ድንበር ፐሪኒ የሚባለው በእንግሊዝኛ እሱ እንዲሁ የመቅላት ነገር ብሩስ ይታይበታል። ስለዚህ በብልት አካባቢ እና ፐሪኒየም አካባቢ መቅላት ወይም ብሩስ የሚባለው ፊቸር ይታያል። ሌላ ግን የምንጠብቃቸው የድንግልና ምልክት መሰንጠቅ ወይ መጠርጠር ነገር አይታይም። ከዛ በተለየ የድንግልና ምልክት መሳሳት አትኒቲድ ሆኗል። ኦርፊሱ ሰፍቷል። የቫጂናል ኦርፊስ ወይም መግቢያው በሩ ሰፍቷል። እንዲሁም የድንግልና ምልክት የምንጠብቀው የድንግልና ምልክት ከልክ ባለፈ መልኩ መሳሳት ይታያል። ይሄ ነገር የሚያሳየው ለእኔ በጣም የተለየ ነገር ያሳየኝ ነገር በተደጋጋሚ ሙከራ እንደተደረገ ነው የሚያሳየኝ። ከኤክስፔሪንስም ከአነበብኳቸውም ነገሮች ከምንሰራውም ስራ በየጊዜው በሳምንት አንድ ቀን እንገባለን ወደ ክሊኒክ እና ይሄ ነገር በተደጋጋሚ በአንድ ቀን የተሞከረ ሳይሆን በተደጋጋሚ የተሞከረ መስፋቱ እና የድንግልና ምልክቱ አትዩኔትድ መሆኑ ወይ መሳሳቱ በተደጋጋሚ የተሞከረ እንጂ የአንድ ቀን ብቻ እንዳልሆነ ነው ለእኔ የሚሰማኝ። ከዛ ቀጥሎ ያለው ነገር መቅላቱ ግን በሰዓታት ውስጥ የተፈጠረ ችግር እንደነበረ የሚያሳይ ነው። መቅላቱ በዙሪያው መቅላቱ ወይም ብሩስ ደም መቋጠሩ ያው የአጭር ጊዜ የአንድ ቀን ወይ በሰዓታት ውስጥ የተፈጠረ ችግር እንደሆነ እንዳለ የሚያሳይ ነው። ተጨማሪ ችግር የሚያሳይ ነው ማለት ነው። ስለዚህ ፒክቸሩ የህፃኗ ከሆነ በተደጋጋሚ ለጥቃት እንደተዳረገች የሚያሳይ መረጃ ይሰጣል ማለት ነው። ምክንያቱም ዝም ብሎ የህፃን ልጅ የብልት መግቢያ ወይም ቫጂናል ኦርፊስ እንዲሁ ሰፊ አይሆንም። በተደጋጋሚ በአንድ ቀን ፔኔትሬቲቭ ሴክስ ወይም ደግሞ ብልቱን ወደ ውስጥ አስገብቶ በአንድ ቀን ውስጥ የተደረገ መድፈር ቢሆን ቢኖር ኖሮ ግን ምንድን ነው የሚሆነው? ይተረተራል። የህፃን ልጅ ገላ ነው በቀላሉ ነው የሚሰነጠቀው። የአንድ ትልቅ ሰው ለአካለ መጠን የተለቀ ትልቅ የተደረሰ ትልቅ ወንድ ብልት ትልቅ ነው እንደምናውቀው፣ ሳይዙ መገመት ይቻላል። እና ያን ያህል ብልት ወደ ውስጥ ቢገባ ኖሮ በአንድ ቀን በዛ ቅጽበት የብልት መተርተር ወይም ደግሞ የድንግልና ምልክት መተርተር፣ መሰንጠቅ እና አዲስ ደም የነበረ ሊኖር እንደሚችል መገመት አያዳግትም። ነገር ግን እኔ የሚታየኝ በተደጋጋሚ ለመደፈር አደጋ ሙከራ እንደነበረ በስሱ ሲሞከር እንደነበረ ነው። መቅላቱ ደግሞ አዲስ ነገር እንደነበረ ያሳያል። አዲስ የተፈጠረ ነገር እንደነበረ፣ አዲስ ጥቃት እንደነበረ ምናልባት። ሌላው ተጨማሪ ያየሁት ነገር በፊንጢጣና በብልት መካከል ያለው ድንበር ፐሪን የሚባለው ላይ መቅላቱ ምናልባትም በፊንጢጣ ከታሪኳ እንደሰማ ነው በፊንጢጣ በኩልም ጥቃት ተፈጽሞባታል ነው የተባለው እና ምናልባት እዛ ፊንጢጣ አካባቢ ፔኔትሬሽን ከነበረ ብልቱን ወደ ውስጥ ካስገባ ፊንጢጣ ይሰነጠቃል። ወደዛ አካባቢም የመድማት ነገርና ደም የመዛመት ነገር ይኖራል እና በዛ የተነሳ የመጣ ሊሆን ይችላል። ያለኝ አስተያየት ምንድን ነው? ህፃኗ በሰዓቱ ወደ ሐኪም ቤት ከሄደች በኋላ ፈሳሾቹ ከተለያየ ቦታ ፈሳሽ ተወስዶ መመርመር ነበረበት። እንደተመረመረ እንዳልተመረመረ በእርግጥ በደንብ አላውቅም፣ ግን ከአፏም ከፊንጢጣዋም ከማህፀንም ዲፕ ገብቶ ወደ ውስጥ ከብልት ጫፍ ብቻ ሳይሆን ወደ ውስጥ ገብቶ የማህፀን ጫፍ አካባቢ ቢቻል ማህፀን ውስጥም ሰውየው ፈሳሹ ከገባ ሊገኝ ይችላል። ምክንያቱም ታጥባለች ምናምን ስለተባለ ለማጥፋት መረጃ ለማጥፋት ተሞክሮ ከሆነ ፊንጢጣ ውስጥም ሳምፕል ተወስዶ ከአፏም ሳምፕል ተወስዶ ፈሳሽ ሳምፕል ተወስዶ እንዲሁም ከብልት ዲፕ ወደ ውስጥ ተገብቶ ሳምፕል ተወስዶ
As you heard from the gynecologist, Heaven was attacked many times before. The proof, the photo shows that she was attacked many times. This was not the first time. Which means, why would he kill her this time? I mean, he got away with rape every other time. Why would he kill her this time? That doesn't make sense. And then, like I was showing you from the research, a pedophile who actually kills tends to hide evidence or put false evidence to mislead investigator. And የምላችሁ ነገር የተለተለችሁ የተባለው it was not there. That didn't happen. So that takes away from the normal pedophile killer that researchers have recorded so far. So this person is extremely unique, or someone else did this. Someone else did this.
ታንቃ እንደ ሞተች የእጅ ምልክት በጉሮሮዋ ላይ እንደተገኘ መረጃዎች ያሳያሉ። ያንን አንቺ እንዴት እርግጠኛ ሆነሽ ይሄ አይደለም ልትይንጫሽ?
እንደውም ተቀርቦ ወዛ የህግ ባለሙያዎች ማለት ነው ከሰፈር መጥተው ያለውን ነገር የሰፈሩንን የአካባቢውን ነገር ሁሉ ጠይቀው መረጃውንን ቢይዙልኝ ደስ ይለኛል። አሁንም ቢሆን ማለት ነው።
ታዲያ ምንድን ነው የተፈጠረው ነው እያልሽኛለሽ? ማን ነው የሚያደረገው? ማን ነው የሚያቀነባበረው? ምንድን ነው እየሆነ ያለው?
ስለ እውነተኛው አምላክ ብያለሁ እኔ ማለት ነው። ስለ እውነተኛው አምላክ እንደ ወላድ ነኝ። እኔም ሁለት ሴት ልጆች አሉኝ።
ውድ ወገኖቼ እንግዲህ እንደሰማችኋት ባለቤቴ ጌትነት አልደፈረም ነው የምትለው። ይሄ ነገር እንግዲህ በሆስፒታል ተረጋግጦ ይህች ልጅ
ናው አማን ጎ ባክ ቱ ዘ ፈርስት ኢንተርቪው ዊዝ አበቅ የለሽ።
በቅድሚያ በደረሰብሽ ሐዘን ሰምቻለሁ። በጣም እኔ ማዘኛለሁ። እግዚአብሔር አምላክ መጽናናቱን ይስጥሽ።
አሜን።
እንተዋወቅ።
ሲስተር አበቅለሽ ይባላል።
ሲስተር አበቅለሽ፣ እንግዲህ ዛሬ ከልጅሽ ጋር በተያያዘ በተፈጠረ አንድ ጉዳይ ነው የተገናኘ ነው። በእርግጥ እንደ ወደኋላ መልስሽ ደስ ይለኛል። ስለ ልጅሽ ቀጥታ ስለ ጉዳዩ ከመግባቴ በፊት ስለ አንቺ ንገረኝ እስኪ የተወሰነ ነገር።
ተወልጄ ያደግኩት ሰሜን ጎንደር ነው። ባህር ዳር መኖር ከጀመርኩ ወደ 10 ዓመት ሊሆነኝ ነው። ከ7 ዓመት በላይ በዚህ ሙያ ስራ ቆይቻለሁ እና ሳልሰስት 24 ሰዓት ከ7 ዓመት በላይ ሳገለግል ሳልሰስት 24 ሰዓት ህዝቤን ያገለገልኩ ሰው ነኝ። ባላሰብኩት ባልጠበቅኩት መንገድ ይሄ ገጠመኝ።
የት ነበረ እየሰራሽ የነበረው?
የምሰራ በቋሚ ስራዬ አሜን የሚባል ሆስፒታል ነው። በትርፍ ሰዓቴ ዲዩቲ ይሰራሉ። ነጋምቢ
እዛው ባህር ዳር ነው።
ባህር ዳር እና ፊላስ የሚባሉ ትልቅ ሆስፒታሎች እሰራለሁ በትርፍ ሰዓቴ።
እንዴት ነበር? እስኪ ምናልባት ልጅሽ ወደ አንቺ ህይወት የመጣችበትን ነገር ብትነግሪኝ ደስ ይለኛል። በጓደኝነት ነበር ወይንስ?
ባለቤቴ ወደ ሰሜን ጎንደር ለስራ መጥቶ ተገናኘን፣ ተጋባን። ከዛ ተማሪ እያለሁ ነው የተገናኘው። ከተጋባን በኋላ ያው ትምህርቴን ጨረስኩ። ስራ ከመጀመር በፊት ነው የተወለደችው። መስከረም 14/2008 ነው የተወለደችው፣ ባህር ዳር ማለት ነው። ከዛ ባህር ዳር ከመቀሌ ነበርን ሄጄ ነበር እዛ እሱ ጋር ስላልተመቸኝ ተመለስኩ። ወደ ባህር ዳር መጣል። ከዛ ባህር ዳር መኖር ጀመርን። ያው ብዙም አልቆየሁም፣ ወደ ስራ ጀመርኩ ማለት ነው።
እስኪ ንገሪ፣ ምንድን ነው የሆነው? ምንድን ነው የተፈጠረው?
ይከብዳል። ልጄን በጣም ነው የምወዳት። አንድ ቀን ታማ አታውቅም። ሐኪም ቤት እንኳ ስትተለቅም የሆነ ተራ ነገር ብትታመም ወስጄ ሰገራ ደም ወስጄ ቼክ እናደርግና መድኃኒት ይዤ እመጣለሁ። ያን ተራ ነገር ነው። ያን ያህል ጠበቅ ያለ ጉንፋን እንኳ ማታ አያውቅም። በሚገርም ሁኔታ ባልጠበኩት ባላሰብኩት መንገድ ሳላስበው ጠዋት እንዳልኩ 24 ሰዓት ነው የምሰራ። ያው ብቻዬን ነው ልጆች የማሳድገው። የሚያግዘኝ ቤተሰብ የለኝም። የገጠር ልጅ ነኝ። ራሴን በራሴ ነው እንትን ያልኩት እና ታናናሾችም ነበሩ። እነሱንም አስተምራለሁ ባለች እንትኔ እንደዛ እየሰራሁ እና የሚገርም ያን ቀን ቤት አደር ብዙ ጊዜ ያው በሳምንት አንድ ቀን ነው የምገባው ቤት።
ማን የሚጠብቅልሽ ልጅ?
እህት ያለች አሁን 4 ነበሩ እህቶች የማስተምራቸው። ያው እነሱ ራሳቸውን እየቻሉ እንትን ሲሉ ሲያገቡ አሁን አንዷ የመጨረሻዋ አንዷ እህቴ ቀረች እና እሷ እኔ ጋ ነች፣ ትማራለች። በትር ሰዓቷ ልጅን ትይዛለች። ኦልሞስት ያቺ ትልቋ 9 ሰዓት ስለምትመጣ ያው በሽፍት
በሽፍት እየተቀያየሩ
ያቺ እንትን ትላለች ማለት ነው። እና ያን ቀን ቤት አደርኩ። ጠዋት ተነስቼ ቁርስ በላን። እንደሚገርም እንቅልፍ ይዞኝ እማዬ ትንሽ ሰዓት ደርሷል ብለኝ ሰርጀሪ ነበር አምሽቼ ነው ማታ የገባው። 5 ሰዓት አካባቢ ነበረ ካሜን ሰርጀሪ ነበር አምሽቼ ገብቼ እና ጠዋት ረፍዷል። አረ እማዬ ትንሽ ሰዓት ሂዷል ብላ ሰዓት አምጣ ስተሳይን ተነሳው ሲስተር ቁርስ ሰርቻለሁ ብለን ቁርስ በላን። እዛቸው እማዬ ተባብለን አቅፋ ላከች። 2 ሰዓት ነኝ 2 ሰዓት ገባል። ስራ ሰርጀሪ አሁንም ስራ ጀመር። ሰርጀሪ ላይ ብዙ ጊዜ ስልኬን ሳይለንት ነበር ማረጋ። የዛን ቀን እንግዲህ እግዚአብሔር ይህን ስሚ ብሎኝ ለስልክ ቦታ የለኝም። ስራና ስራ ብቻ ነው እኔና ስልኩን ዝም ብዬ ሳይለንት ሳላደርግ ብቻ አድርጌዋለሁ። እና እኔ መንካት አልችልም። ስክራብ ነኝ። ስክራብ ማለት ከሐኪሙ በሆኑ እቃ የምታቃብል ስተራይል ነህ። ምንም ማንሳት መንካት አትችልም። እና ስራ ኦልሞስት እንትን ጀምረናል፣ ከፍተናል። እዚህ ጋር ፍራክቸር ነበረ። የሆነ አማራ ባንክ የሚሰራ እንትን ቤት ሲሰራ ወድቆ እሱን እየሰራን ከፍተናል፣ ጀምረናል ስራ። እዛ ስልክ ተደጋጋሚ ይደወላል እና ምንድን ነው ስልኩ? ዶክተር ወርቁ ይባላል። የአጥንት ቀዶ ሕክምና ሐኪም ነው። ተደጋጋሚ ይደወላል ስልክና አንሱት። ምንድነው ስልክ ይደወላል። ከዛ ራን የሚያደርገን ልጅ አለ። ራን ማለት እቃ ያቀብላል። ከዛ እሱ አንስቶ ያበቂያለች ልጅ ታማለች የሚል ነው የተነገረው። እና ከዛ ሲስተር ልጅ ታሞብሻን እየተባለ ነው። 2 ሰዓት አሁን እኮ ነው የገባው። ደግሞ ገና እንደመጣ እንደጀመር ነው። እኔ ታመመ ልጅ የለኝም ስል አይ ሲስተር ጊዜው አያስተማምንም፣ እስኪ ተመልሰ ደውል ይለዋል። ተመልሶ ሲደውል አዎ ያበቂያለች ልጅ ናት። በኋላ ሰው ወጣ። እንዴት እንደወጣ ሰው ይተካ ተብሎ ሌላ ሰው ተተካ። እንትኔ ብቻ ነው ከላይ ያለው ጋውን ብቻ ነው ያለቁት፣ ሌላውን አልቀየሩም። ቀየሮጥኩ እየበረርኩ ሂጄ ባጃጅ ጋር ገባ። ወቃ ውሰደኝ ነው ያልኩት። ባጃጁ ስገባ ጓደኛ አይተኝ በራ ገባች። እየበረርን ወደ ቤት ሄድን። ወደ ቤት ስንሄድ ማንም የለም፣ ክፍት ነው። ልጆቹ አይጠፉም ነበር እዛ ሰፈር፣ የገበሬ ሰፈር ነው እንግዲህ እዛ ቤት ተከራይ ሁኜ ከቆየ 2 ዓመቴ ነው። እና ልጆቹ ከብቶቹ ምናምን አይጠፉም ነበር እዛ። ያን ቀን ማንም የለም። እዛ ቀጥታ ቤት ስገባ ሰውየው የቤቱ አከራይ ቁጭ ብሏን ሶፋ ላይ ቁጭ ብሏን። በጣም ነው ማከብረው፣ በጣም ነው እንደ ወንድም ነው ማየው። እንዳልኩ ሚስቲቱ የኔ ቤተሰቤ ናት። እሷም ብዬ ለልጆቹ ዋስትና ብዬ ነው እዛ ቤት የገባው እና በጣም እንደ ወንድም ነው የምንቻየው። እና ጌች ነው ስሙ። ይህች ምንድን የተፈጠረው? ድንጋጥ ያለ ደንግጫለሁ። ምንድን የተፈጠረው ነው የምለው፣ በቃ ምንድን የተፈጠረው ነው የምለው። እና ዝም ብሎ እንዲህ ቁልጭ 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 ያለኛል። ለካ ድርጊቱን ከፈጸመ በኋላ ከቤት ቁጭ ብሏል። ተከትሎ መሄድ አልቻለም። ገባሁ፣ ምንም አያናግረኝም። ገባ ወደኛ ቤት ሄዱ፣ ማንም የለም።
ማን ይህን ድርጊት የፈጸመው?
የቤቱ አከራይ።
አንቺን ቤት ያከራየሽ ሰውዬ?
የቤቱ አከራይ ሚስቲቱ ዘመዴ ናት፣ የሶስት ልጆች አባት ነው። እኔ ሁለት ሰዓት እንደወጣሁ ሶስት ልጆች አሉት የሱ ይህ ልጅ ጓደኛ አለችው። እና ሚስቲቱ ክትባት የእህቷ ወልዳ ክትባት የአርባ አምስት ቀን ልታስከትብ ወደ ሆስፒታል ሄዳለች። እንግዲህ ታስቦበታል፣ ድንገት የተደረገ አይደለም። አስቦበት ቆይቷል። ሲጠብቃት ነው የቆየች ልጅኝ አላወቅንም እንጂ ስትሄድለት ያው ልጆቹ ብቻ ነው የሚቀሩት። ብዙ ጊዜ ቤት ነው የሚውለው እሱ፣ ስራ የለውም፣ ደላላ ነው። እና ስትወጣለት እኔ እንደወጣሁ የእኔ ልጅ እና የእሱ ልጆች ውጭ ላይ ቅጠል ቆርጦ ይጫወታሉ። ሲስተር ናት የምትነግረኝ። ከዛ ሚስቲቱ ወጣ እንደሄደችለት ታታ ትጠራቸዋለች ብሎ ያስወጣቸዋል የእሱ ልጆች። ከዛ የእኛዋ ትነሳና ወደ ቤት ትመጣለች። እኛ ቤት ቤቱ የእሱ ቤት ከጀርባ የእኛ ቤት ከፊት ነው። ስትመጣ ታታ ትጠራቸዋለች ብሎ አስወጥቶ ግቢውን ዘገውጌች ብላለች ነው የምትለው። እና በቃ እኔ በጣም ጎበዝ ናት፣ በትምህርታ ሁለተኛ ክፍል ነበረች አሁን፣ በጣም ጎበዝ ናት። እና በቃ እኔ አባከስ በጣም ጎበዝ ናት እና አንብቢ፣ ምሳ ሰዓት እመጣለሁ። አልመጣም ግን እመጣለሁ ነው የምላት ውሸቴ። እና እመጣለሁ ብያት ነበር የሄድኩት። እና አንብቢ ትመጣለች አለች ምሳ ሰዓት ብያልኳት አለች። ገባች ቤት ሽንቴ ልጅ ና ብላ ሄደች ነው የምትለው። ውሃ ስጭኝ ብላ ሽንቷን በሸናች ቁጥር አስለምጃታለሁ። ውሃ ነው የምትታጠበው እና ካልታጠበች ያቃጠለኝ ነው የምትልና ሽንት ቤት ስትሄድ ውሃ ይዛ ነው የምትሄደው። ውሃ ሰጥቻት ውሃ ይዛ ሄደች ነው የምትለው። ሽንት ቤቱ በር ላይ ውሃ ተቀምጧል፣ ሳትጠቀምበት እንግዲህ ሲጠብቃት ቆይቷል። ልጁ ናት እና የብሎ ቤት አስገባት። ከሱ ቤት እንዳልኩ ከጀርባ ነው የሱ ቤት፣ የእኛ ፊት ወደዛ ይዞረ ነው። ሌላ ማንም የለም ከግቢው። ተከራይ ደግሞ አንድ ነበረች። እሷም ለካ አጋጣሚ ውጭ ቤት ወጣ ሄዳለች። ካስገባ በኋላ ያው አሸዋ ሁሉ አዘጋጅቶ ጠብቋል። አሸዋ አፏ ሞልቷታል። ደፍሯታን ሲደፍራት በፊንጢጧን በማህጸኗም ነው የደፈራት። እና እንዲያው ባሳያችሁ ካልፈራችሁ አለ እንትኑ ሕክምና እንትኑ ላይ ትንሽ እንትን ገብተው ይዘውልኝ ነበር እና ሰባት ዓመት ከሰባት ወር ትሆን እንጂ የአምስት ዓመት ነው የምትመስለው። በጣም ደቃቃነች፣ በጣም ደቃቃነች። እና በፍንጢጣዋም በማህፀኗም ነው የተጠቀመው። ማህፀኗም ፍንጢጣዋም ተበርግዷል። ይሄ ጀርባ አጥንታችን ብቻ ነው የሚታየው፣ ማህፀኗ የለም። ደምታበታለች፣ አፍኗታል። ይህን አንገቷን ያነቃት ይሄ እንደዚህ እንደገባ ነው የተገኘ። አምስት ጣቱ እንደዚህ እንደገባ ነው የተገኘ። ከዛ በኋላ ሳፋ ላይ አድርጎ በጣም ደምታበታለች፣ ሳፋ ላይ አድርጎ አጠባት። ካጠበ በኋላ በሩን ከፍቶ ወስዶ የትጥላታን እኛ ደጃፍ ከእኛ ደጃፍ ጥግ ልጆች የሚጫወቱባት ዝም ብላ ልሾ ነገር ሁና ኬንዳ አለች። ዝም ብሎ አንዳንዴ ሻወር ይወስዱ እንወስድባታለን። እዛችን ሻወር ልትታታችን ዝም ብሎና ልጆች ነው የሚጫወቱባት፣ ከኛ በር ጥግ ነው። እዛ ጋር ወስዶ አስተኝቷታል። ሲያስተኛት ያው ምላሱ ሲያስተኛት ያው ምላሷ እንዲህ ሲይዛት ተዝልዝሎ እንደወጣ ነው። እና ይሄ በሙሉ አረፋ ነው። ልብሷን አውልቆ ነው ያጠባት። እና ልብሷ ትንሽ ከኋላ እንባ የምታክል ጠብታ ትንሽ እየደም ነክታለች ቀሚሷ። ያን ካረገ በኋላ ማታ ጥቤ ያሰጠሁት ልብስ ነበረ። እዛ ግቢ ማንም አይገባም። በጣም ተፈሪ ነው ልጁ። ማንም አይገባም። ዘመዶቹ ራሱ አይወጣም የሚፈሩት። እና አስጠን ነው የምናድር፣ እቃችን ውጭ ነው የሚያድረው። እና ጥቤ ያሰጠሁት ልብስ ነበር፣ ሻርፕ፣ የእሷ ሻርፕ አለች፣ ኩፍያ ጋር የምትለበሰው ሻርፕ፣ እሷ ሻርፕ አውርዶ በቅርብ ሁኔታ በቅርብ እሷ ዝጋት ሁኔታች ትንሽ ያቺ እንትን ልሾ ያልኩ ሻወር የምትመስል እዛች ጋር አስራታን ሻርፓን ወድቃ ሞትች ለማስመሰል ከዛ በምላጭ ጥሏታን ተጠልሶ ነበር። እግሮቿን በምላጭ ወድቃ ሞተች ለማስመሰል ደግሞ በምላጭ እንዳለ ተጥሏታን ካረገ በኋላ መድኃኒዓለም ታምሩን ሲሰራ ወደ ሌላ ቀይሮ ቁጭ አረገው። ቤት ግቢውን መክፈት አልቻለም። አቅፎ ሲያመጣት ደግሞ አንድ እግር ጫማ ቤት ቀረ። አንድ እግር ጫማ ሬሳዋ ከመጣ ለታሪክ
አበቀለሽ lied when she said she worked 24 hours a day. But nobody works 24 hours a day. No one. So there's one lie. And then the second lie is she says that she worked 24 hours a day for the people of Ethiopia. That's another lie. She didn't do it for the people of Ethiopia. She did it for herself to survive. She needed the money. You could almost... Within 6 minutes of the video, you already know that this woman has a money problem. She's a single mother. Her husband left her. She admits that she's caring for her children all on her own. Not only that, she says that she has no family that helps her. And then seconds later, she says that her sisters are the ones helping her keep watch on her daughter. So she contradicts herself within like 2 minutes of her statement. She says, on one hand, she says no family helps her. And then on the other hand, we find out that it is the family that helps her. And the other thing is, what kind of mother comes home only once a week? That's strange, isn't it? And then she admits that she had spent the night at the Amin Hospital during surgery. And then she came and slept that night. In the morning, the daughter wakes her up to go to work. And then that's the day that the daughter dies. That's very suspicious. How come the daughter was fine all week long? And then the night that the mother comes to sleep over, that's the time the daughter dies. And keep in mind that the rapist, so-called rapist, probably had raped her many, many times, according to the gynecologist. So that means that he could have kept raping her and he didn't have to kill her. He has no motive to kill her. Yeah, he may have raped her, but even that, we will see later. A pedophile that actually kills usually stages the crime scene and so on and so forth so that he doesn't get caught. But in this case, the crime scene being set up is to show that he is the one who did it, because he left one shoe in his house and one shoe outside where the body was found. That demonstrate that he's the killer, but that means that he didn't set up that crime scene. Someone else did. And that, I believe, is Abigailish. Abigailish did that. In my opinion, she's the only one that could have done that. And then the other thing is, ሰውነቷ ተተልትሏል የተባለው የነበረው, you know, some injuries on her body, that apparently didn't happen. So that's another lie. And people are waking up to these little details. And then the other thing is, Abigailish is the one that spends 24 hours dealing with cuts and bruises and things like that. She is the most capable in that house to have done such a thing. She would have the tools to do it too. And she will also have the knowledge to implant body fluids from the men, since they all use the same restroom. So it's very easy for her to plant the body fluid into the little girl's vagina and then said he raped her. And in the story, you find out that Amin Hospital is not even that far. So why is she spending? She only comes once a week. How come? How come she doesn't pass by even if to see her daughter? If anything, she has neglected her daughter anyway. There is another detail that nobody is speaking about. Every one of these women involved, Abigailish, Yesoyo, Mist, Yesoyo Rasu, the sisters, everybody has cell phones. Cell phones can be tracked. And then we can literally pinpoint where they were at the time Haven died. You know, what time did Abik Elash left the house to go to the hospital? What time did she leave the hospital to come to the house? Where was everyone at that time? The cell phone towers could tell you exactly where those phones were. That means if you can, this is done, Ethiopia is using cell phone towers. So we could know where these people were. Instead of taking their word for it, we should go to the cell phones and locate where those cell phones were at that time. And that's very easily doable. You know, this happens all the time in crimes investigation. And that has not been provided by the authorities. And that's sad, because that would have actually cleared out a lot of things. Instead of, you know, for example, the wife of the accused person says that he had come with them all the way to the hospital. And then Abik Elash is saying that he's at home all by himself. So the stories don't match there. But anyway, like I said, the cell phone towers data, the data technology, you know, it would have proved everything to us. You know, that should have been the first thing that the police should have looked at. That's all I have for today. Well, there's one more detail that I didn't speak about, is the motive. There is no motive for the man to kill Haven. There is no motive. However, Abik Elash, from the beginning of the story, just as it starts, you understand that she's living a life that is very frustrating. She spends 24 hours at work. She never comes home. God knows what she's doing. She doesn't have any money to keep up with two children. She lives, like you saw the house. It looks like it's a terrible place to live when you look at it, you know. But she doesn't even own that kind of house, you know. Doing the job she's doing, she's renting. So that means like she's really, really not doing well in life. And then on top of that, she has two kids that she has to feed. And on top of that, Haven was born, she's 7.5 years old. 4 years out of the 7 years is COVID. So COVID made everything expensive globally, including Bahrain. And as you can see in the video, it's been 2 years that she's been living in this place. So God knows where she was living before. This is supposed to be the better place out of where she used to reside. Just keep in mind all these details. So this place was actually more desirable to in her eyes than the other places. So you can imagine how bad the other places could have been, okay? Now, this place was a better place to live at, and to me it looks like a gutter, to be honest. But this is where she chose her daughters to live at. And she can only rent this place. She can't even own this place if she wanted to. So that means she's really struggling in life, and there is a motive to get rid of the daughter. And we will see. I'm going to introduce another story where mothers actually kill their children.
She never indicated that she was hallucinating, delusional, or had disordered thoughts or speech.
Definitely a danger to herself.
Massachusetts mom Lindsay Clancy allegedly killed her 3 young kids. Now, moms around the country who have experienced postpartum depression and postpartum psychosis are sharing their stories.
When you're in psychosis, you're not there. It's not her.
Christina Beetham was overjoyed when her daughter Mia was born.
I just thought I was, like, so happy. I was like on cloud nine.
But postpartum symptoms also began to appear.
While I was in the hospital, like I was laying there and I distinctly remember a little shadow moving by the bathroom and it freaked me out. There would be like birds that would fly to the window and I would like swear that it was like an ancestor that passed away, like a grandma. Which at first it was very comforting. And it wasn't till night when like I was started getting scared that I'm like something is might be wrong. I'm like, why won't she leave me alone?
About one or two mothers out of 1,000 will experience postpartum psychosis.
Basically, it's a psychotic episode, which means the individual may have hallucinations, delusions. They're really obviously not thinking straight and getting disconnected from reality.
Christina's friend and husband brought her to a psychiatric hospital as an involuntary patient, but she didn't realize anything was wrong until days into her stay.
I was like screaming and crying. I did not want to go. Didn't want to be away from my baby. I was very fighting it, because when you're in psychosis, you're like, what's wrong with you? Like, why can't you just be happy for me? But looking back, it really was what they said, postpartum psychosis.
Dr. Pagato explains that hormone changes and life changes may cause postpartum symptoms.
There's a lot going on hormonally after childbirth. Now, there's also a lot going on in your life after childbirth, and any mom knows this. So what we also might have going on is sleep deprivation, a lot of changes physically in mom's body, a lot of worries, a lot of anxieties. Now there's this baby that we have to take care of.
After giving birth to her daughter, Dr. Pagato experienced postpartum depression firsthand.
I should be happy, and why do I feel this way? Why aren't I more excited? Why do I feel like I want to run away from all of this?
Like Christina, Dr. Pagato was not aware something was wrong until later.
I've experienced depression before. It felt very different. When you're in the middle of it, it's hard to see. And like I'm a psychologist, I should be able to see.
Even though her symptoms subsided on their own, Dr. Pagato warns that postpartum depression and psychosis can be life-threatening if left untreated.
It can get quite severe, where a person may actually experience suicidal ideation or, you know, actually make an attempt to suicide. When you're delusional, you may think, for example, that somebody is going to kill you if you don't do something. You'll hear voices that are telling you things. You're really not of your right mind. And that needs to be treated. People resume their right mind and actually sometimes be very, very shocked at what they've done.
Lindsay has been charged with the murder and strangulation of her three kids. Her lawyer says she intends to plead not guilty by reason of insanity. She currently remains hospitalized with round-the-clock care.
Kurtz, mother and daughter are booked into the Stevens County Jail.
So wait. They married each other?
Because they're in their right mind to marry their mom.
The mother and daughter married each other?
Yeah.
Huh.
Patricia and Misty Spann married earlier this year. A DHS and police investigation revealed this pair is actually mother and daughter, blood relatives who somehow married in Comanche County. Patricia Spann lost custody of Misty and two other children when they were young. They're adopted by their grandmother. Patricia Spann insisted to investigators she didn't have contact with her kids until 2 years ago. And when she reunited with Misty Spann, her daughter...
This book is very, very important for all men, and particularly Ethiopians. You know, in the West, we are told that we should listen to the women, we should communicate with the women, and the woman is a goddess, and so on and so forth. She's the main player. But the Bible says quite different things about women. In fact, the women are the source of sin, problems. Whether you are a father, she's kurtamat not ilal. She's not a positive entity in life.
The fact is, if this woman, Abek Elish, had not come to this house 2 years ago, this man would still enjoy his house and his family. He would have lived peacefully in his modest home, even though it doesn't look good. That was his home. He was happy. And then this woman came with her child and her sisters and things. And look, now he's in jail. He's spending 25 years. The country wants to kill him. You know, and it goes hand in hand with what the Bible says, basically. You heard it. It's hard to swallow for women, but it's true. It's a fact. Now that we covered the Ethiopian Orthodox Tewahedo view on women straight from the Bible and Andamta, and the case actually reading it for you, now we know that crime can occur from women, horrible crimes. In fact, sin started from women, so we shouldn't be surprised. The other thing that I wanted to cover is the cell phone towers. Each individual had cell phones in the story, so that means we could pinpoint where they were at the time they were making calls, at the time they were traveling from the house to wherever, the hospital or Tankwaibit, whatever. How many were there? How many people went there? And we will clarify whether or not the man who Gitch was actually all the time, if he had stayed behind in the house, like Abik Elich is saying, or he actually went to the hospital with his wife and the others to the hospital, and then when he returned to the house, he was arrested. So we could clarify without taking anyone's words, but the data, the cell phone data, the tower will tell us exactly where they were. Also, we would know the exact time the call was made to Abik Elish to tell her that her child is sick. So we would know exactly when Haven died, because according to Abik Elish, she left to work between that time and the phone call. That's when Haven died, right? But I suspect that Abik Elish killed her before she went to work. That's what I wanted to prove, that her phone would tell us when she left, when Abikalesh left the house to the hospital, and it will tell us when she came back from the hospital to the house. And we would also know the time she received the call from whoever it was to tell her that Heaven is sick. This way we'd know, we would have a time frame that's reliable, and I'm sure it will clear out all the confusion. So I push everyone to try to ask the cell phone data, the towers, the providers should give us this information so we could investigate this case further. Also, I will push for a lie detector test to each one of them, as well as DNA test for everyone, because maybe the second child that Abikalesh has, maybe Yagich Lijlion Ichlad. We never know. We just never know. We want to know if these two people had another kind of relationship. We don't know. We don't know what goes on into this in this house. So it would be good to have a DNA test to prove whose child is who, who's the father, who's the mother, is there anything beyond the story? And that's what we'd like to know. So the cell phone proof, that would be a good start. We should have a lie detector test as well as a DNA test for everyone.